Hello, everybody. This is Russ Puryear with Solux Technologies. I want to thank you for joining our customer webinar, How a Wireless Giant Became More Agile by Control of Its Data. Today's guest speaker is Susan Ng, who's the IT Director of Cricket Communications, which is the fifth largest wireless provider in the U.S. with over 4.8 million subscribers. We're very pleased to have Susan. She's got over 25 years of software engineering experience, primarily focused in Oracle technologies. She's got over 15 years as a Oracle DBA, and she's been with Cricket for over 8 years. And as you'll see from the presentation, she's extremely bright. She's got a PhD in molecular biology, so be careful the questions you may ask. With that, let's get started. I'm the Vice President of Sales here at Solux, and what I'd like to do is very quickly do a quick overview of our agenda. I'll talk just a few minutes about Solux, and then I'll turn it over to Susan. Real quickly, Solux is 100% focused on information lifecycle management, and our specialty has been focusing on providing archiving solutions for packaged applications, primarily in the Oracle world. We support not only Oracle Business Suite, as Susan will be talking about, but also other packages such as PeopleSoft, Siebel, JD Edwards, and Bond as well. Our solution is OEM'd by Oracle, and they bundle it in with their banking application, FlexCube. And one of the unique things about our solution is from a single platform, not only can we do the archiving, which Susan will be talking about, but the same product can be used for application retirement or for creating small subsets for test and development or masking that data in the test developments to secure any sensitive data that you might have there. The other thing that's a little bit unique about our solution for those of you who are thinking about getting into archiving is Solux offers several different ways of purchasing the product, not only the traditional perpetual license, but we do have an annual subscription license, which can make it very easy to get into without requiring having to secure a large capital budget. We also offer a cloud solution, and we can do managed services as well. On the right-hand side, you can see some of our Lighthouse accounts, done business in these different areas, you know, in the finance with MasterCard, Energy, Duke, logistics, et cetera. So we've been providing archiving solutions since 2004 and have got many well-known accounts. And I'll bring up a quick slide here. You may recognize some of these names. Or they might even be your accounts that you're with right now. With that, I want to go ahead and turn this over to Susan Ng. Susan?
Hi, Ross. Thank you for your introduction. Hello, everyone. I'd like to just make a quick update there. Since the webinar was scheduled, I had started working for a phone recycling company called E-Recycling Corporation in San Diego as a senior director, enterprise assistant. Since I was the one who implemented Solux in Cricket 4 years ago, and then I'm still an employee at Cricket. So I'll give today's webinar on behalf of Cricket to share with you my experience with Solux archiving tools. So the first slide shows you what Cricket communication is. It is the one of the wireless carrier, and it's providing the customers with no credit check and no contract to sign. I think a lot of people probably know this because Cricket is it's nationwide. Next slide, please. The parent company is Leap Wireless International, and it's a public company under the symbol Leap. Cricket is actually part of Qualcomm before 1999, and it was a spin-off of Qualcomm in 1999. And it's headquartered in San Diego, California. It has 35 state market places, and it went nationwide in 2011. It provides to over 4.8 million customers the wireless service in the U.S., and it's fifth largest wireless provider in the U.S. Next. The reason we implemented the archiving solution for Cricket is in 2010, we were in the process of implementing Oracle order management, inventory management solutions for Cricket. During that time, in the design phase, and then when we discussed with the business, we realized that the implementation is at the inventory transaction, is that the inventory transaction items are processed at serial level, which means the data in EBS in the modules related to order management and inventory will grow significantly, and then that data growth will impact inventory transaction process. Not only that, the EBS inventory processing will provide data downstream to a forecast replenishment and reporting system, which essentially provides the report to the warehouse to feed into the warehouse to let the warehouse management know that how many phones and accessories need to be transported to each of the stores. So essentially, we have to have this daily report out to the warehouse and then have that replenishment down for the stores at the nationwide level. This is why if there's a delay in the inventory processing in EBS, it will significantly impact downstream inventory reporting. So, and then when we look at it and discuss with the business side, we realize that not all the data in the EBS inventory order management modules are needed for the daily and monthly processing. Therefore, we reached a conclusion that at the time of implementation, we only need 1.5 years data inside EBS, the active data, and we can archive the rest into the archiving tables and archiving databases. So next slide, please. So we discussed with multiple archiving vendors and researched their archiving solutions, and the one we picked, actually multiple of them at the time of evaluation, and then mainly we focused on the three modules in EBS plus a few of the archiving related, the custom tables in EBS. So the three modules are order management, inventory, accounts receivable, and shipping, plus the custom tables. So what we did is that eventually we picked Solix out of all the four vendors we evaluated, and we implemented a data archiving solution that improved the performance for the EBS inventory management, order management, AR, shipping, and the daily processing. And then that meets the business requirement to process the inventory data in EBS within 10 hours and then provide the data downstream to JDA application to do the reporting. Next slide, please. Why we consider Solix? You know, out of all the solutions we evaluated, I think multiple of them that all look pretty similar in terms of the way they discussed about how the data will be stored in different archiving databases and how the process will run in EBS. But then we look at the cost. The most driving force is actually the cost for the implementation and the maintenance contract. Because Solix provides the lowest, the best solution at the lowest cost, and then that was the key selling point to our CFO and the CIO. On the other hand, we also considered Solix for its reputation, because at the time of inventory order management implementation, actually it's the Oracle technical team provided us the name Solix, when we considered the archiving solution. And then not only that, we even heard the rumors saying Solix will bought up. It's one of the products Oracle will consider to buy out. And then we like to have the close relationship with Oracle, because that not only for the daily application support, but also down the road for the upgrade. And then also Solix has a lot of experience, more than 10 years experience on the EBS archiving. And one best thing for the business side when we showed Solix the demo to them is, they can, within the EBS application itself, they can see the current data, the historical data, or both through different application responsibility manual, and that's the ease of use is one of the key selling points for the business users. Next, please. So we implemented the Solix architecting solution with the help from the Solix implementation team, and then the implementation was less than 2 months for the implement. And we achieved about 4 million inventory transactions every month since June of 2010. And this implementation ensures data volume in the inventory, order management, shipping, AR will not impact the daily process for the inventory or the concurrent requests inside the Oracle EBS related to order management, inventory, AR, and also we saw a significant improvement in the daily processing. One of the things I would like to share with you is during this past 3 years, almost 4 years since the implementation, during some of the times, you know, like we couldn't do, like our schedule was doing the archiving every month, once a month, but then, you know, sometimes because of quarter end, year end, or, you know, or the auditing process there, we are not able to do the archiving. And then, you know, we probably stopped doing that for like 3 or 4 months there. And then actually the business side will actually reach out to IT to say like, you know, we really need to do this one because, you know, the processing is getting delayed and then the downstream reporting is not getting done on time. So that's why I say, like, if you implement a right solution there, actually business do benefit from it, and then they are the driving force for the IT to do the provide the services. Next slide, please. So the recommendation, when to consider archiving and purging, I think one key point is at the beginning of implementation, any solution implemented, you need to think what the data will do, and then what the data, what is the data considered to be active, and then what's the data that can be archived. The reason is not only to the application performance there, and also for the data processing, and then for the scalability, and also for the database operations. You know, it's almost always easier handling less data versus more data there, considering most of the customers you will have to deal, I mean, in the IT world, you have to deal with performance issues. Having less data is always a good thing for you. And also during the implementation process, you need to engage the business partners. This is a very important part because the business actually decides what's the current data and what is the historical data. For example, during our implementation, business decided they were not easy with, you know, like to say, like one, you know, that we can archive that much data from EBS. So what they did is they agreed on 1.5 year data inside EBS. Down the road, you know, like within half a year, I reach out to the business data, you know, is it possible we can just retain 1 year data inside EBS, and then, you know, older than that goes to the archiving database. The reason I made that decision is when I looked through the data access there within EBS, I realized the users hardly access any of the archiving data there since we archived, because they're mainly focused on the active data, so there's essentially no point to keep those, you know, older data inside the active databases. So therefore, they agreed on to, you know, later downstream, the monthly archiving became any data older than 1 year old. And then at this point, I have suggested the business to say, like, you know, let's just keep half of your data inside EBS. The reason is the database has grown because we have many different modules in addition to inventory and order management. We have many different financial modules and HR modules there. So our database is like over 5 terabytes. So having that archiving solution there will really help to maintain the data growth there. So the last thing is, when you do the implementation, you need to work closely with the vendor because the vendor implementation team has a lot of experience on the EBS modules. They are the one actually will know and then will guide us to say like which module and which base tables in each of the modules that are related, interrelated. For example, you know, when you implement inventory order management archiving solutions, at the beginning of the implementation, Cricket team, IT team did not realize that we need to archive shipping. We need to archiving AR together with that. It's actually the vendor Solid team, implementation team, suggested us, you know what, based on the data you want to archive, actually you need to do the four modules together. So that's why I say you need to work really closely with the vendor because they do have the knowledge of what data is related to each of the processing, daily processing, and then so that way all the data sets are archived together instead of, you know, some of the data, you know, from different modules are left inside your archived database and then some of them in archiving database. And then not only that, you know, the out-of-box solution we provided needs to be modified. The reason is different company has a different data retention plan and also the business rule could be different. So in fact, they have this GUI in the Solid archiving tool that you can do manually, you know, like update those queries for the selection criteria. Then that way you can select the right data. But again, you have to work with the vendor to make sure. Vendor Solid to make sure that, you know, this is the correct thing. So both sides, from the vendor and then from the IT, will agree on that, and then you present it to the business what you archived. Next, please. Hello? Okay, so I'm done. Any questions?
Yes, thank you, Susan. So at this point, let's open it up for questions. Please send, for those of you who haven't already, please go ahead and go into the chat box and send questions to the Solix Marketing, the host. And while you're doing that, Susan, I've got a couple questions that have come in already. Okay. First question came in regarding the training of the users. Can you talk a little bit about what training you provided to the users and what type of issues, if any, did the users have with the new system?
Solid solution actually it's almost like a native application. What happened is you know they build custom build application menus. Responsibility within EBS to fetch data, you know, like you can query the data inside the from the archiving database or within the active database. They use different application responsibilities to do that. So that makes it very, very easy for the user. The reason is that they only need to switch the responsibilities to look for the data, whether it's historical, whether it's current, or whether it's both, when they do reporting or when they do a query their inside Oracle EBS application. So the training became a pretty easy thing because they are already, you know, the users are already EBS users. So we gave trainings on the, you know, like a training class there inside the, during the implementation, during the UAT process there to show the users that, you know, use this menu, you can do this exit. You know, manuals are defined right by the name, right? So you can always put archiving in there or historical data in there, and then the user will understand immediately what that means. Then they will know what to do there within the EBS. So we don't really have any issues there for the users during the implementation and after implementation in terms of how to retrieve the historical data.
All right.
Did I answer your question?
Yes, I think so. Thanks, Susan. Here's another question. You mentioned that the out-of-the-box solution needed to be customized. Was this true application customizations or just configurations? And let me respond to that one a little bit first, and then Susan, you can add to it. So this is referring to the Solux product. It is really just configuring for the particular implementation. So the Solux EDMS software is always maintained the same for all customers, and what we do is just configure each individual implementation. So we have out-of-the-box pre-packaged archiving templates where we know the business rules and the tables that need to be archived, and what we do then is just relax some of the rules for the particular customer's needs and maybe add any additional custom tables to that. Susan, is there anything you would want to add to that, or is there anything additional that you were referring to when you talked about customizations?
Yeah, I think Rossi already pretty much answered that question there. I think the thing we changed, you know, like because business requirements are a little different from the packaged application. So say, for example, what do you consider data as a candidate for archiving? So that drives you to make some modification on the select query there, because basically Solix provides those queries already inside that configuration menu there. So what you do is you just need to add like maybe a one more where clause there where, you know, or something is closed, the status is something, you know, like based on the table there, you change a little bit there. So that's the change we made, like a custom like that piece of the selection criteria. And the other thing is
Oh, that's all right. Got another question. Besides cost, what makes Solix archiving solution better than the other competitors?
Solix archiving solution are pretty lightweight, so it doesn't really impact any of the, you know, like daily processing during the archiving process there. So like what we do is we schedule a time there to do inventory order management archiving, and during that time, actually, the other process is all still going there, you know, like for finance and HR and purchasing. We have many, many different modules. So those are all still ongoing while we're doing the archiving, and then there's no significant impact there. In fact, the user doesn't even know that we're doing archiving in the background there. And besides the cost, I think the knowledge base there in Solix is pretty good. You know, like easy to reach to the support. That's one of the key factors. I mean, I've worked in Oracle technology for so long, and in fact, I would say even try to reach to the Oracle support, it's a very difficult thing. You know, like most time they give you this level one support that will not even able to provide you any of the solutions when you open a file with Oracle. But the Solix, you can get to the people pretty fast there to get your issues resolved. Not only that, even the sales team, they are very good at getting you the support if you need it. You know, like how do I say it? You know, my experience with different vendors that usually when they sell you the product, they're very good at it. They're so eager to sell you, they're so friendly, and once they sold it to you, you cannot reach them at all, and then you have to go through the technical support. But Solix is different. I think that everybody's very passionate for that way. When you have an issue and you couldn't reach to one of the key members in their team to do the support, you can reach out to even Ross there. You know, I've done that a couple of times because, you know, the guy was on vacation or something there. Anyway, so that's one of the other advantages, the easy of supporting and then to easy to reach to the technical person. And I think that's plenty there to think about, but the cost is the main driving force, because I think that all the solutions for EBS, they all talk about similar things, you know, but you do have to consider cost in there, and then it's easy to sell to your CFO when you want to write up the purchase order.
Great. Thank you, Susan. One other thing I would add to that is one of the big differences is that Solix from a single product can not only be used for archiving, but it can do the subsetting and do the masking. Solix created its own product from ground up, so it is one product, where the other vendors require multiple products to do the things that we do with one. So you've got multiple products to manage, and you've got more expenses as well. And then Susan talked about the customer support issue. Gartner, in their 2011 study, pointed that out, that Solix customers are all extremely happy, and when you talk to the references, we'll all rave about our support and are willing to go above and beyond. Got another question, Susan, for you. It said, I'd like to know the difference between archiving and subsetting.
Ross, why don't you start first?
Let me help with that one. Yeah. So archiving is basically relocating closed transactions out of the active production database, designed to increase the performance of the production database. We're subsetting. The idea there is to take a small subset for out of the production system to be used for test and development. So in an archiving situation, as Susan talks about, you've got to keep, you know, 1 or 2 years in the production database for data that's being updated or may not be closed. But in the test and development environment, you can take it, you may be able to create an instance that only has 3 months of data in it, or it only has one particular organization. So it's taking it one step further. It's just creating a small subset of just a limited amount of data for test and development. And then on top of that, you may want to go ahead and mask any sensitive data in that, you know, such as Social Security, credit cards, bank information, et cetera. I've got another question. Boy, they're coming in here fast and furious. Who managed the SOLIC system?
It's the, how do I say, the daily process of the, well, actually it's a monthly, right, because you don't run the archiving purging every day. So what you do is that you do have a database that hosts all the historical data. That data is through database link, it's linked to the Oracle EBS data. So essentially your FCBA is managing data for the archiving data. And also, I use the FCBA to run the monthly archiving process there. So to me, it's I own the Oracle EBS group there. So that's why I think it's one group there. I have a functional analyst in supporting the inventory order management team, business team, and also have FCBA. So they are working together side by side during the monthly purging archiving process there to make sure, you know, once you archive, there's a process. So it's very flexible. So that once you archive, and then you can check to see if the archiving data is the right data that you want to purge, and before you're purging. And then once you purge it, then you also need to make sure that that purging went cleanly. Also, so that's why I think that it's the EBS team owns that better. EBS team with FCBA.
Okay, and there's a follow-up question to that. What percent of the DBA's time do you think needs to be allocated to running the archiving system?
It's once a month. I mean, that's based on us, but if you need to archive more frequently, then it's only the time that doing that is wrong, during that processing time that you need to have the CDA to do it, and it's agreed-based. So essentially, even if you have an offshore team, I do let offshore teams run it also, because it's going to run, depending on how much data you have. So the time that DBA needs, it really depends on how big a volume you try to archive there. So I do use onshore and offshore DBA both during that weekend to do the archiving. And it's not significant. The reason is it's running, it's a Java-based application, so it's running, at its cost, like how long it runs depends on how much data you're archiving. But each of the process there, you do need the DBA to check in from time to time to see if the process is still going, and if it's finished, do some simple queries to make sure the data archived is the correct set of data, and then it's all. I usually ask them to do a run comp also to make sure the comp is correct before they do the purging.
So would you say if you were advising a company mm-hmm. on how much time they should allow additional work that might be putting onto the DBA, would you say it's a quarter of an FTE or half FTE, anything, any guidelines?
Less than quarter. I think it's very, because it's only like a, before Cricket we run monthly, so it's only that weekend when we run it. It's probably, I will say maybe additional 20 hours for one of the, for one of the onshore DBA, and then maybe 5 or 6 hours of the offshore DBA, because it's mainly monitoring that process to run to make sure it's complete, right? So I would say, that weekend alone, okay, for the whole month. Other than that, you don't really need to have this SOLIX GUI running there, because you're not using archiving and a solution there. The only thing is you need to make sure the databases are running fine. It's connecting to the EBS database, which is a daily operation, and then it's just one database, one extra database to take care for the FCBA. So that part, I wouldn't count anything in there. It's all the regular database operations.
Okay. So there's a question here, and I think this one may be difficult to answer. How long does it take to archive 1 terabyte of data?
It depends. You have to, I really have to say it depends. Depends on how many modules in there. what the selection criteria is, because you know, the more complex, you know, like interrelationship modules, then it will take longer for the select. Right? In the meantime, it spends on the select to fetch out the data, you know, like the data set that needs to be archived. So that time drives the time for the archiving. So for us, 4 million for records there, you know, we don't work even in the weekends. We do like a, say like we schedule with the inventory team to, you know, like those processing will not happen during that weekend. So I gave them the whole weekend. The reason is I do want people to sleep also, so that's why we have a whole weekend. But in fact, I think it's probably 8 or 10 hours you can finish all that 4 million rows, which is how do I say it? It's interrelated. It's not like a very simple query that you can just go fetch it within a few minutes. So it really depends on how complex data is. And then the query, the select query decides how long it would take for your one terabyte.
So your archiving would typically be done once a month, and you would do it over a weekend for 10 hours or so? Did
yeah.
I read that right? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Another question is, where are you archiving the data to?
I'm archiving to an Oracle database, residing on the same database server. So, and then because it's important, you have your database, your archiving database, and then your EBS database kind of close to each other. The reason is that you're fetching data through the database link when you launch those applications, EBS application, and then click on those menus to retrieve the historical data. So you do need a fast connection there between the application to the historical database. So my suggestion will be on the same database server.
Perfect, okay. Another question, can the archiving job be invoked by an independent scheduler? And I'll take this one. So yes, Solix has three ways of actually kicking off the archiving job. It can be done through the GUI interface. It can be done through Solix built-in scheduler. And we also have a command line interface that could be used with any scheduler that you might have as well. Let me be sure I didn't miss any questions as they were coming in here. Bear with me 1 second. Do you have any estimate of the percent improvement that somebody should estimate that they would get by implementing an archiving solution?
In money or in time?
Yeah, I think they're referring to percent improvement for the performance of the application. You know, would this be 25%, 50%? What did you see, and what do you think a typical implementation might see?
Okay, so I'll give you the example I have. During that, after implementation, you know, there was a phase there where we were doing auditing and then also doing the annual report there, and then we were not allowed to do this archiving because everybody was busy. And the inventory team needs to do that job because usually the annual season are the ones that we're high selling season also, so that's why inventory module cannot go down. So we were not able to archive for like about 2 or 3 months there. Without the archiving, actually the process supposed to finish within 10 hours. I think it doesn't get completed until 16 hours later. So that actually blew out our window for the reporting. And then that's only because we didn't do the archiving for about 3 months.
All right, so there's a couple other questions here. What is the maximum data size supported in one single archiving process execution? There is no limitation to or maximum size. So basically what limits the amount of archiving is typically just the archiving window. So as Susan talked about, clients will typically have a weekend window or 10 hours, whatever that might be. And so that's typically the limiting factor, not the size of the data. And let me see if I
Yeah, I can add a little bit more there. You know, see, like sometimes when the business tells us, you can have the whole weekend, you know, like starting from Friday night all the way to Sunday morning. So what we do is we do 2 months archiving at that time. So that way, we can skip one downtime there. But the other times when they say, like, you only have, just the Friday to Saturday to do it, then we will just do 1 month. It really depends on, like what last day. It depends on the downtime, how much downtime you can get from that particular module. So again, downtime is not like the whole application is down. It's just that particular module is not running any requests.
So can you expand on that? Can the user still be using the system while you're archiving?
Yes, but not for that module. Like say, for example, inventory order manager, I would not let them do it. The reason is you don't know what they're going to do during that time, right? So, but if it's a GL, AP, procurement, purchasing, OTL, the HR modules, we have many modules, and fixed asset, those things, yeah, you can all go in there, do stuff while that's going.
Okay. The archiving doesn't lock them out, or doesn't take the database down. You just prefer not to have users accessing it while it was doing that process.
I just don't want the business users for that particular module to be in the system while I'm doing archiving.
Got it. Okay. Here was another question. Do we have a club license of all packages like archiving and test data management, or separately licensed separately for each of them? I'll go ahead and answer that one. So Solix licenses it both ways. So we do have bundled packages where you can purchase bundles that have multiple licenses together, or you can buy them separately, sort of as needed. So you could start with archiving and then later add subsetting and then later add masking, or you could buy them as a bundle and save some money up front by purchasing a bundle. Here's another question. Are you using Solix for any non-application specific archiving, such as a data warehouse?
Not at Cricut here, but how do I say it? For Cricut, the budget was only for the Oracle EBS modules, so we actually licensed eight different modules there, even though we only implemented four. I would have to say, we should have implemented all eight at once, so that way, it's all inside that project budget there that you can do it, because having the four left over there, it's difficult to get the budget, It's part of the business, sometimes people agree that they give you the money to do the implementation, other times it's a little more difficult. So for data warehouse, Solid Solution can do that also, right, Wes?
Correct. Yeah, Solix as a archiving solution can not only archive any of the package applications we've talked about, but it can also be used for custom applications as well as data warehouses. that's all the questions that have come in, and I'll tell you what, we'll give you maybe one more minute. These have been great questions. I appreciate it, and hopefully that the answers have been helpful for everybody. So let me give you, I'll let you catch your breath. We'll give the audience here another minute or so to get them in, and then we'll go ahead and close this off.
Yeah, I would say, if you are considering the archive solutions, this is a good one to consider. The reason is the EBS is pretty complex. So I actually personally try to do the archiving myself, build custom scripts and then custom program to do the archiving, and then I would say I failed on that. That's why I picked one of the leading vendors in the market there versus my own in-house built solution.
All right, one more question has come in. We're planning to do an R12 upgrade. Would you recommend archiving before the upgrade or after?
Generally before the archiving, because the archiving, how about the upgrade, you have a certain downtime window there, and then if you don't do that, the data volume can be affected for the time, for the downtime. So I think one of the key benefits to implement archiving is reduce the downtime for the upgrade.
Yeah, and I'll add to that, and we're seeing that as well. Right now, a lot of the clients who are contacting us are considering upgrading to R12, have found that the downtime exceeds their, you know, allowed by the business or desired by the business. So they'll ask us to come in, do the archive, then they'll go ahead and do the upgrade, then we'll come back and upgrade the archive instance, and that reduces the total downtime. Okay, well, I think that's it. Well, Susan, I want to thank you very much for all those in the audience sending all the questions. Thank you. I think that made it very interesting and interactive. Hopefully, very helpful for all of you who might be thinking about archiving here in the future. This WebEx will be saved and available, I think, in about a day or so. So if you want to come back and re-listen to it, please feel free to do so. Susan, thank you very much.
Thank you. My pleasure.
Bye-bye, everybody.